Good morning, Kingdom Fun, third and fourth grade ministry. This is the lesson for Sunday, August 2nd, 2020. I am Miss Allison. The title of today's lesson is Fruit of the Spirit. We're going to read scripture reading Galatians chapter 5, verses 16 to 26. Our Bible memory verse is Galatians chapter 5, verses 22 to 25. And our focus today is live by the Spirit. So we talked about the title where it says Fruit of the Spirit, Live by the Spirit. So I want to make a connection with thinking about a tree. So start describing the traits of fruit on a tree. What do you notice? What do you see? They hang from the tree. They are different colors. They're sweet. A lot of them are sweet. They have that naturally sweet taste. They contain a seed that will make more of that same tree. They're seasonal. You won't see a mango tree all year long. Well, maybe in tropical countries, but maybe something else like what would you see? A cucumber. I'm growing cucumbers in the backyard. I'm not going to have them all winter. I'm having them now this season, but they won't be here all winter. And they're different sizes. So think about these fruits on a tree as we start reading our Bibles. So get your Bible out and let's move to Galatians chapter 5, verses 16 to 26. And we're going to be looking at how do we live by the Spirit? Galatians chapter 5, verses 16 through 18. So I say, walk by the Spirit, and you will not gratify the desires of the flesh. For the flesh desires what is contrary to the Spirit, and the Spirit what is contrary to the flesh. They are in conflict with each other, so that you are not to do whatever you want. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under the law. So, what does it mean to, how do I walk in the Spirit? Well, it tells you, it says, when you're walking in the Spirit, you will not gratify the desires of the flesh. So thinking of the flesh is being able to control your tummy. There's a commercial where the person changes who they are. So it could be a woman and she changes into this man and she's like screaming and everything. And then they give her the candy bar and then it satisfies the hunger. So she's out of control because of the flesh, because of her hunger. Okay. So that's an example of like those desires of the flesh. But when you're led by the Spirit, you are under the law. You are under God. You're listening to God's command. And if you notice, the desires of the flesh are opposite to the Spirit. Let's continue reading. Galatians chapter 5, verses 19 through 21. The acts of the Spirit are obvious: sexual immorality, impurity and debauchery, idolatry and witchcraft, hatred, discord, jealousy, fits of rage, selfish ambition, dissensions, factions, and envy, drunkenness, orgies, and the like. I warn you, as I did before, that those who live like this will not inherit the kingdom of God. Those who live like this will not inherit the kingdom of God. So how do you live by the flesh? because we got to know what that looks like so that we know when we're going in the wrong direction. Huh? And so some of them I'm going to talk about, some I am not. Though some of the that they mentioned, those are conversations you could have with your family. But hatred, having hatred for someone. Okay? So during this time when we're talking about a lot of race debates and all those things, don't have hatred for someone else. And so this is a perfect lesson to talk about those fruits of the spirit and how to use it in talking about race and injustices with others. Not to have an impure heart, thinking, I hope she trips up those steps. That's an impure thinking of on someone else. That's an impure heart. That's an example of it. Discord, having disagreements with other people. Like you're purposely getting in arguments with someone else to have discord. Jealousy and envy what someone else has. And so you may ask your parents over and over, like, you have to have this because someone else has it. That's jealousy. Dissensions. So dissensions can lead to discord. So you could have a disagreement and then it could get bigger where there are groups that break off into different factions. And so you don't want to have that in any type in your home, at school, anywhere you live. Having fits of rage. Have you ever seen someone just all of a sudden start yelling and having this bad temper? Or sometimes we call it road rage. You see people out in the street and they yell at you or blow the horn. And so those are living by the flesh. Those are some examples. So let's go back to the Bible so we know how to live by the Spirit. Galatians chapter 5, verses 21 through 26. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things, there is no law. Those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. Since we live by the Spirit, let us keep in step with the Spirit. Let us not become conceited, provoking, and envying each other. So, the passions and the desires, if we belong to Jesus Christ, those passions and desires of the flesh have been crucified. Amen. So then how to live by the Spirit? What is that fruit that we're talking about? So thinking about that tree that we talked about earlier is what are we going to see the fruit of your life? I should see love. I should see love to your siblings and to your parents. How do you show love? Picking up after yourself. Offering a soda to someone, some water, having joy and not grumpy. It's hot. Not grumpy. You want to have joy about today. What a wonderful day. We needed the rain and today was raining. Wonderful. Forbearance. You have patience. You show patience to one another. Kindness. So some things you may not want to say because it may not come out kind. And so you want to be kind to one another. Okay? Peace. You want to live by the Spirit. You're in peace. Goodness. Faithfulness. Self-control. Self-control. We can control what comes out of our mouth. And so you can be angry, you can get upset about something, but you have to control what comes out of your mouth. And so That's where you call on God. You pray so that he can help you control what comes out of your mouth. Okay? He is always there to help you. And gentleness. So this is how we live by the Spirit. These 9 fruits of the Spirit should be evident in our lives. So if you think about the tree that we talked about earlier and now, you may see self-control at different times. Do you see love and faithfulness? So they could be seasonal. They could be different times. You're not going to see all 9 all the time. And then also, they may not come out. You may not see them all. They may not come out at the same size. They may be in different colors. So they're, you know, so sometimes you may have more joy than another day, but it's there. And those are the fruits. So just think about that as we do this lesson. So let's review. And this review is a little different because I have 3 questions that I want you to kind of think about as you have some family devotional time. Is question number 1. It says, what does it look like when you live by the Spirit? So have that conversation with your parents and your family. What does it look like? And which fruits of the Spirit do you think you're doing pretty well on? You know, maybe it's self-control. Like, you are real mindful. Even when you get angry, you don't have a temper tantrum. You don't have fits of rage. So you can control that. You feel like God has really helped you in that area. And so you don't need help with that. But then I want you to think about which fruits of the Spirit do you need to work on? Because that leads you right into your prayer. Identifying those areas where, God, I still need your help. So even you may have self-control in one aspect handled, but there may be something else, like you really love cake. And, you know, now is the time where people are baking and so you're eating too much of it, you know, so you have to have that self-control. So think about those things where you need help in your fruits of the Spirit. Memory verse, Galatians chapter 5, verses 22 through 26. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. Those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. Since we live by the Spirit, let us keep in step with the Spirit. Let us not become conceited, provoking, and envying each other. So let us pray. Father God, we just thank you for this opportunity to fellowship together and to identify the areas where we need to work on our fruits of the Spirit, Father. And so that we know if we call on you, you will help us. And so we just thank you for just making us more like you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. So remember, we love you at Kingdom Fun. Be safe and hope to see you very soon. Bye-bye now.